There's bees all over me. Bee tings. Look at that thing. Anyway, I'm gonna stand. If this shit is fun and this is all you want to do and this is all you think about, the grind is easier than you think it is. You know, it's like whatever you put your energy into, that's what you're gonna get. So if you're grinding and all you really think about and talk about is, oh, I want to be successful, I want to get money, I'm trying to get it popping on Instagram, I want to get more followers, why don't people follow me, like people sleeping on me, I need to get placements with Drake, I need to start getting this and that, and then you're racking up all these like things that you don't have, and then you just get frustrated, and then you're pissed off, you're slowly kind of like going into a deep place. For me, I never went to that place. Like, I never went down that rabbit hole of like pressuring myself and thinking that like I need to like make more money and go to school and do this and do that. Like, I put all that negative shit out the way and I was just like, man, let me just make beats all day. And man, it fast forward to now and it like kind of, it worked, you know what I mean? Like, I pulled through, I weathered the storm and like I made it through, you know what I mean? And it took a long time, but I made it through. And so I really believe that that's true for everyone. You know, any one of you guys that are really just like trying to pursue the music shit and really trying to like make it, like focus on the art, focus on your craft, and the grind won't be as hard as you think it is. Mental health is really a big deal. Not only in the music industry and not only with like creators, but just with human beings in general. I'm not a professional, you know, I'm not a therapist. So I don't have all the answers, but I always use my own experience as an example. And that's where I pull inspiration from, is what I've seen and done in my life. Going back to your question, in terms of like the 6 years in my mom's basement grinding and like trying to make my parents happy and them pressuring me to like go to school and get a job and stuff like that, all of that shit was real and it was hard. There's a lot of pressure. Stressful, tiring, but the thing that kept me going was doing what I loved. I mean, nothing else got me through it except for the fact that I just committed myself to just making beats all day. I didn't have any money. I was pressured every day from my parents. I was pressuring myself, but like I let all that shit go and I just focused on just making music. And making the actual music was what got me through it, right? Because I would wake up in the morning and literally just like eat breakfast and then just go right into the studio and just make beats all the way up until I had to go to bed at night, you know what I mean? So it was an all day thing for me, and I enjoyed every single moment in there, whether it was like making a beat or chopping a record or whatever it is. Like, I had so much fun doing it. It was like playing video games, you know what I mean? And so that's what kept me going, and like I was unstoppable because like no one could tell me to stop, and no one could pressure me into not doing what I wanted to do. That's what you need to kind of, I think, keep in mind, is how do unknown producers reach rappers for placements? Man, that's just like and no offense to you, man, but first of all, that's like a cop-out question. Like, that's a bullshit-ass question. Like, that's like me saying like, yo, how do I become rich? Or like, how do I make $1 million? Like, yo, fuck you, bro. Like, I can't tell you that. Like, you gotta go do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I apologize if that is offensive, but like, how do I get my beats to big rappers? Like, bro, like, watch my YouTube. Honestly, like, I'm not even trying to like be funny and plug my shit. Like, watch my YouTube. Go to YouTube and do tutorial videos. Like, go around and talk to people, meet other creatives, you know, go listen to my podcast. Like, you gotta just be honest with yourself and start executing, man. Like, there's no fucking, like, magic formula. Like, it does, like, working with big rappers and big artists, like, that shouldn't even be on your radar yet, you know? So you'll get it, man. Like, you'll start to really, like, realize that eventually, you know? Like, when you put the work in and you realize that you love making music and that's all you want to do, then you get to the point where you realize, like, okay, man, like, this is my shit, this is my calling. Now let me create a strategy to try to get myself out there and start working with people and work my way up, you know what I mean? Be open-minded and try stuff, you know what I mean? That's a great age to try to discover what you really want to do with your life. And if you go through that process and you realize that, like, making music is all you want to do, making beats is all you want to do, you want to download Fruity Loops or learn how to engineer, like, pursue it, you know what I mean? Don't do it for the wrong reasons. Do it because you love it and you fell in love with it and you're passionate about it. That's how you're gonna grow, you know? And then just start trying stuff. Make beats, try stuff. Don't be afraid to fail. Don't be afraid to, like, make shitty beats. Like, if you're just starting, like, you're gonna make shitty beats, you know what I mean? So just challenge yourself, have fun. That's my main thing. Like, just enjoy what you do, man. Because if you're looking into being a music producer and it's more frustrating than it is fun, then I don't think you should be a music producer. It's just not going to be for you. I'm 25 making beats for 2 years and they are still trash. Should I chalk this up to a hobby? Listen, if you're 25 now and you said you've been making beats for 2 years and you just said they were trash, like, I don't know, man. I don't know you. I haven't met you. I don't know your full situation, but just based on that comment alone, it sounds like there's some lack of, like, confidence there. That's kind of what I'm feeling. That's the undertone that I'm hearing, like, in that comment. This is what it boils down to. If you're really, really passionate about making music, making beats, singing, rapping, if you're really, really, really passionate about it, and it's all you think about and you do it every day, you'll never quit and you'll never think about quitting. You know, the idea of quitting will never, ever, ever, ever enter your mind. Ever, not once, not even a little bit. And that's what separates the people that make it and the people that don't. The people that think about quitting are the ones that are just halfway passionate, you know? Passion is a strong thing, guys. Like, if you really fucking love something and you're so passionate about it, quitting is not even an option. Having a deep passion for something and having ambition is a big one. Passion and ambition, dude, if you love something and you have enough ambition, there's nothing out there that's gonna stop you, nothing. And that's just facts. Like, that's just 100% facts. Some of you guys are infatuated with this shit. There's a difference between real love and infatuation. Are you infatuated with making beats and being a producer? Are you infatuated with being a rapper? Are you infatuated with being a singer? Maybe. You know, and that's okay if you are. You just need to find your truth and find out what you're really passionate about. But yo, there's a difference between infatuation and love, man. Are you infatuated with the game? You infatuated with being a producer, or do you love being a producer? Or do you love this shit? Because sometimes when you're really young or when you haven't experienced enough in life, it takes a long time to realize, and that's okay, man. You know what I mean? Everyone's different. That's important to realize at some point. So, all right, guys.